Hey guys, my name is Shalane and welcome to my YouTube channel. Alright guys, so this weekend is going to be a big weekend. I am entered in a barrel weekend, so I will have two runs. And I have a run tonight, Friday night, and I will run again tomorrow on Saturday. So, I got the horse trailer hooked up, and it is about 11 o'clock now. So, and ignore the paint on my hands. I've been doing stuff and things, which I will see that in just a second. But I've decided to do something a little bit different. I showed my mom it last night and she's like, it's different, which means okay. But we're gonna see how tonight goes. By what it sounds like, tonight I am actually going by myself, so, which is not uncommon for me actually. All last year I was traveling by myself, which I was only going about 20 minutes from my house to an hour away from my house, which this is really no different. So this is a little bit further than an hour, but I said I've traveled by myself before. I know how to get my horse ready by myself. I know how to change a tire, so I think we may be okay. I checked my tires. They're all good. I'm trying to think of what else. Sonny's going to pack his supper tonight, so he will be able to eat before we make a run tonight. I'm trying to think of what else. He's going to get therapy done on him tonight, which we're going to do the PEMF MagnaWave stuff. We're going to go ahead and try that on him tonight before his run. So, and then he's going to hang out for a little bit longer to... He's gonna do that, I think, a couple hours in advance, so we're gonna do that, and I took off the day of work to be able to do that. So, we are gonna do that, and then he's gonna go hang out at the horse trailer, and I'm gonna feed him, and he's just gonna chill. Oh my god, you just thought... Oh, I'm sorry, I'm editing right now, so I'm seeing how past me thought that Friday was going to run easy, and it didn't. I was running all over the place. It didn't go as smoothly as I thought it would. I showed up. I fed Sonny right then and there. We probably had about 30 to 40 minutes to get ready because I had gotten the call to do the flag. So... It was a mess. In other words, here is what happened. What had happened was, I was driving on Friday. I thought I was going to be able to get there and get on time and just do my little MagnaWave therapy and stuff. Nope. I was driving, had one of the ladies call me that they had asked me to carry the flag, which I wanted to, obviously. But, so, I agreed to do that because Sonny can carry a flag. And so we got there. I went ahead and fed him, like, about as soon as we got there. Then I maybe had about 30 to 40 minutes of a time frame to let him eat, get him saddled, me change my clothes because I did not show up in the red shirt. I had a little t-shirt on. Anyway, so... put the red shirt on. I had to put my pants on because I wore shorts there, and got him over there, and we were warming up and stuff, and then I brought him back. Nope. I'm trying to think why I had to go back. Oh, I did take him back to the horse trailer. I took Sonny back to the horse trailer after we carried the flag, unsaddled him, put all the stuff in there, and then I brought him over to the MagnaWave stuff. Then I had to go back and get my saddle, then bring it back, then get back to get redressed again. And then when he finished his therapy, then I went back to go get him saddled. It was a mess. It was a mess. So past me just thought it was gonna be easy. Anyway, I'll let y'all get back to this.
I'm gonna chill, and then I think we're running after 7. So yeah. So I will be showing y'all some more footage when we get to the barrel race, but I gotta go get a shower and everything. So I will see y'all in DeRidder. Alright, so I am walking down here to crawl through a barbed wire fence to feed my horses. So I have really gotta get better at videoing while I'm at a barrel race, but at the same time, it's like I'm a little bit too focused on barrel racing to even video. So yeah, my nails. I need to go get my nails redone. They're like 3 weeks old, I think. I don't know. About 3 or 4 weeks old. Close to a month. So, hi, Foxy. Hi, Foxy girl. Hi, pretty girl. And little baby Zezay. Oh. Baby Zezay, what you doing? What are you doing? He's
by myself to the barrel race. Halfway there, I get a call from a number in Lake Charles. And I've been getting a whole bunch of robocalls lately, especially with local numbers. So I ignored it. And then I had a call immediately from like Opelousas. And I was like, okay, I feel like somebody is trying to get a hold of me. So it was actually Miss Heather that was helping put on the cancer run. And she had asked me if I would want to carry the American flag during the national anthem on Friday night. And I was telling her, I was like, he said, lucky for you, I just so happen to have a horse that carries the American flag. And then this happened. So yeah, I was able to carry the American flag. And we had this run. So shut your mouth and run me like a river. Shut your mouth, baby, stand and deliver. Holy hands, holy baby, it's enough. Like a river, like a river. Shut your mouth and run me like a river. Choke this love till the veins start to shiver. One last breath till the tears start to wither. Like a river. So good, and that was like the best that he has turned his third barrel all year, I think, just about all year, since last year for sure. But I was so excited for his run, and then we had ended up being 10th in the 40. I'm sitting here watching her because she's bad at feeding time, so apparently the only time that she's calm is when I'm right here with her. But we ended up, I think, 10th in the 40 overall in the open, and then in the adult side pot we were 3rd, so out of the money for Friday. But then Saturday, my boyfriend came over to watch, and we had a little bit of a struggle on the first barrel, but nothing. She's bad. But nothing that was too terrible. I felt like he was a little bit stiff on his right side for sure. So. Great. I mean, he does so good and he's so consistent. I was looking the time that he had ran for Friday night versus Saturday's run, he was only 6,000 of a second slower than Friday night. So, Foxy. So I was so excited that he was about the same times. I'm pretty sure if he would have loosened up a little bit more on his neck for his right side, that we probably would have landed in the money. But consistency is key. Friday night, we placed 10th in the open on the 40. Saturday, we placed 11th in the 40. And we placed 3rd in the side pots on both days. So I can't be too mad at him. We haven't really been able to barrel race a whole lot this year, so I was excited to be able to do that, and especially going in this pen and running a 15. Like, I don't know if we've ran a 15 in DeRidder yet. So this weekend we didn't get one, but we got two. So I was really excited about that. I went ahead and brought Sunny home, and I thought I was sitting in the money, so me and my boyfriend decided to do like a little date night out of it. We went by there. I got me some of my pictures that are right here. I wasn't able to get a whole lot of them because Sunny did not give me quite the best angles because he got so close on his second and third barrel that I was like halfway out of the saddle and like all over the place. So I was like, I'm gonna have to let him know that I need better angles. But anyway, we had a great weekend. I feel like by the time that we were starting to head back over there, I had looked at the live feed and somebody had actually went in and like ran like a 14.2. So that bumped us out a good bit for sure. So I can't be too terribly mad at him. He was really consistent through the whole weekend. But now he's gonna get him a break. But with him getting up there in age, and I think Foxy's getting close to being healed up completely, I think I may go ahead and start doing some groundwork on her. So she will probably be coming in to some of the 2021 early races and rodeos coming up. So, and then I've got Foxy that I'm wanting to start competing on next year. Plus, Sensei is going to be starting getting broke and everything, like saddle broke, ridden broke. I may get broke in some form or fashion, whether it's money or bones. She's gonna start getting her 2-year-old training in over the summer next year, which will be done by me. And I probably think what I'm thinking about doing is just going ahead and working on her for a good 60 to 90 days and then just turning her out, because since she is what they are considered a long yearling, because she was born like summer of last year, so I'm thinking about holding her off till she's technically her 5-year-old year to maturity her. So I think I may go ahead and do like 60 to 90 days and then give her like a good 60 to 90 days off. So I'm not only am I in the middle of trying to work on seasoning her, work on running Sunny. I am going to be breaking Seze, and it's all over the place next year. So said I need to double down and get ready for 2021 because this is going to be a wild ride. But yeah, I hope that you guys enjoyed this vlog. My hair is all up on top of my head. We have been cleaning up. The tractor shed is gone. I started cleaning up the trash and stuff in the barn today. I wasn't able to get some stuff taken down or anything up there yet. So probably for next weekend or a couple weeks from now. I'm not 100% sure. But we are all over the place trying to figure out what's going where, who's doing what. So, and we're just incredibly busy. I am surprised that I'm actually starting to catch back up on these vlogs with everything going on. I know that I was not putting them out as often as I wanted to over the past month or so. So, we will be... Foxy is done. So, I hope that you guys enjoyed this vlog and... We may see y'all next week. I'm not 100% sure. So, there's always something going on around here on the hill. So, I'm sure there will be something to come out. All right, guys. See y'all.